Welcome back. So, video number two for the night. But this one's kind of special to me because this one is from BlackDolphin90, all the way from Ireland. I haven't ever gotten any package from Ireland before, so that's totally awesome. I'm really excited to see all that's in here. We had talked a little bit about what we were trading, and so he told me some of the items that are in here. And without further ado, let's get into it. I'm kind of surprised that it came all together, because all he used is tape across here. So I'm kind of surprised. But at any rate, we will. It does look like it's all there, and it doesn't look damaged, so that's awesome. I'm pretty impressed. But note for anybody sending packages, it comes that way, yeah, it does. Tape, lots and lots of tape. Wow, sweet, literally sweets. Well, those are kind of cool. They even got little leprechaun heads on them. Neat. Lucky leprechaun lollipop. That's awesome. That's cool. Very neat. Okay, look at all these goodies. All right. I'm already seeing some awesomeness here. It's a Chubb. I have not picked it. Wow, holy crap. Did you hear that? Yeah, that's got some spring tension on it. I have not picked any Chubbs before. Now, I do remember from our conversation that he said he was sending a couple of Chubbs and that they were on loan, so I will be sending these back to him. So, man, that is a spring tension on that. Wow. Okay. Yeah, wow. Pretty good bidding on that, too. Look at that lows with the highs in the back. Yeah. Good stuff there, man. Wow. Okay, cool. Let's see. Oh, this is the other Chubb. Okay, cool. Looks like this one has a removable. Holy crap. Wow, I guess all of them have spring tension, like heavy. That's got a heavy spring tension there and on the shackle. Holy crud. Listen to that. Yeah, that's nuts. Okay, it's not key retaining. Pretty good bidding on that. Got a low in the front and highs all in the back. So, yeah. Sweet. And that one is guttable. So, yeah, cool. I'll have to check those out. Awesome. I see a zone. Cool. I've not picked a zone yet. Okay, that one's not a very strong shackle on that one. Does not look like, it looks like it has a removable core, but I think it's got a pin there, so I don't think that core comes out. It is not key retaining either, and has pretty good bidding on that. Look at that. That's good bidding for a padlock. All right. And a Yale-style keyway to boot. So, yeah, all right. Let's see what else we got here. Oh, a Yale. Beautiful Yale. All right. Nice. Don't see a key. Oh, whoa. Okay, I'll show you what I got, what I saw, but I don't see a lock to match it. I see a key in here, but I don't see a lock for it. So hopefully it didn't get jacked. Hopefully you just sent a key to scare me, and you did. That, my friends, is an Asa Twin Combi key. No lock to go with it, though. Because that is an era. So, yeah, no lock to go with this key. Hopefully. Hopefully he just sent the key to scare me. And he did. Let's get back to this Yale. Pretty awesome looking Yale here. No key with that, as far as I can tell. Looks like we have a Bergwachner Magno. Huh. It says something in German there, and I have no idea. 400E40. You know, I've picked a Bergwachner small one. Never one quite this big, so this is a little bit bigger. Awesome keyway on that. That's cool. And really good bidding, too, actually. Yeah, pretty good. Wow, that kind of worries me about that asset. You'll have to let me know on that, on this key. Hopefully you just sent the key. Got a little tiger. I see tiger. Yeah, that's pretty awesome. Works perfectly. Wow, look at the bidding on that. Little thing packs a punch with that bidding. That's pretty cool. Alright, that's awesome. Let's see here. Let's get to this one. Because this one, if I remember correctly, he... and it doesn't look like he has a tag on it, but we will tag it for him. This is an ERA. An ERA. He told me he was pinning this one up for me, so this is a challenge lock, so that'll be awesome. Looking forward to that. Yeah, quite a bit of play in that. Does not have the clip on back. He says it didn't know if I wanted to pick it with the clip on it. I probably will, because I think he did that because he didn't have a key for it, but that's okay. We'll take that chance. And it looks like we have a Lentz, which is awesome. This is another thing he had told me. It is a little 5-pinner. And wow, pretty good bidding on that too. I have not picked a Lentz half euro before, or a euro cylinder. I've picked the padlocks, never picked the euro cylinder, so that'll be awesome. Then he told me he was wanted me to pick this one. This is a 10-pin dimple with slider. So he raked this on his channel and got it open, quite a bit of back and forth with this thing and got it open, but he said he'd like to see me single pin pick it, so I will have to get that done. It is a Hangyan. Okay, I think Trekmaster 30 got the other half of this, if I remember correctly. But yeah, that'll be a fun one to get into. So looking forward to that. And it looks like he sent me a awesome keychain with the P for Pick Me. Luck of the Irish, Ireland. So that's awesome. I got a lucky key ring. So very cool. That is totally awesome. Thank you so much, BlackDolphin90, for all these locks. I'm just looking forward to this. You'll have to let me know about this ASA twin combi key. That's got me freaked out. You know what? He told me that these Chubbs were on loan. One is guttable, one is not. I'm going to pick these out of the package. Let's see if we can get into these. We're going to start with the one that's not guttable. Hopefully I can get into it. If I can get into it in a reasonable amount of time, then we will... here's the bidding on it. Then we'll go ahead and do the other one, and I will gut it. That way I can put your package in the mail, because I will send these back in the package that I have for you. I waited to send it because I thought, well, if I'm going to be borrowing something, I might as well just send it back to you when I send the package. So, yeah, let's get that in the vise. See if I can do something with this. Never picked any Chubbs, so this should be fun. All right. I think that keyway looks pretty wide open. Should be able to use my gem. Yep, I can get that in there just fine. Let's see if my 50 fits in that. And it does. Awesome. Okay, let's zoom in for you guys and get any kind of view that I got going on this. Hopefully, can get through this. Let's see here. Just pull, start in the back of the lock, pull forward, search for binder. One is binding. Okay, got one. Went to a false set. Oh, I just touched four or five. I don't know how many pins this is. I think it's a 5-pinner. Counter on three. Okay, I got him set. Okay, I just touched four and got it a little bit deeper. Now I'm getting counter on four. Oop, I think I overset him. Okay, I just touched five and got it back. Two. Okay, got him set. Oop, just touched five and went deeper. And now I'm getting counter on five. And that was it. Okay, awesome. Got him open. Sweet. Alright, that was the Chubb. brass padlock. Let's see. Hold on. I know this is going to be a long video, guys, but I want to know. That is a 50 millimeter brass Chubb. Awesome lock, man. Full of spools. Cool lock. That's neat. But I will be able to put this one in the package that I send you back. So that's awesome. Cool. Now let's see if we can get into this beauty here. This is a chunky, heavy padlock. Nifty. I think it is a, it's a 50 millimeter as well with a removable core. Let's see something here. Nope, not key retaining. Okay. All right, let's get this in the vise. See if we can get into this. Let's see here. A bit bigger. Hopefully I can get into this with it being a removable core. It might have something else in it, but I can tell you this, it has one hell of a spring tension on it. So that's going to make it really tricky if it has spools. Let's zoom in for you guys. You can see any kind of view of anything I got going on with this one. There we go. Pull forward, search for binder. Happens to be one. Okay, I just got a false set off of him. Let me move my vise here. Okay, I got a false set off of him. I'm searching for a counter. Four. Okay, got to click on him and got him set. Three. I don't know that I got him. Tricky. Two. Okay, got to click on him. I think I got him set. Okay, that was three, and I think I don't know if I were set or not. I think I'm getting counter on. Oh, maybe not. Okay, I dropped everything, I think. Let's go back and try this again here. Sorry about moving around on you guys. Just trying to feel what I got going on in here. Okay, got my false set back from one. Four. Oof, I keep oversetting. The spring tension is tough on this lock. Okay. Wow, he's tough. I think I'm just playing with spools, but I keep oversetting them. Makes me wonder if these have tapered pins in here. Three. Okay, I got him set. Two. Okay, got him set. I think that was one. Four. Five. it's four. Okay, I got a click on him. I think I may have got him set. Three. And it's open. Wow. All right. Yeah, that Chubb's tricky. I'll give you that. let me zoom out and hopefully, come on, zoom out. There we go. And hopefully we can get this gutted before I run out of battery. wow. Two videos in one night kind of eats the battery a bit, but it is picked, as you can see. But the spring tension on this lock is insane. I could see why that would be a tricky pick, and it was. So let's see. It's got a Phillips head. Let me get my pinning tray out. I want to see what's inside this. I also want to see if it was just the spring tension I was fighting, or if there is some kind of tapered pins in there, because I was really oversetting. Let's see here. Yeah. Tough little lock, man. Ooh, wow. I don't think you've been into this, because that's not wanting to come out. I'm going to have to grab a bigger screwdriver. Wow. May not be getting this right now. I may run out of time. I'm going to grab a big screwdriver. Okay, here we go. That is on there tight. Okay, I got it. Whew. Wow, that was on there tight. I guarantee there's some... Wow. I don't know. If you gutted that and you put it back together, man, you need to, work out. You were working out. Awesome. Looks a lot like a American core. It is still gooey in there, though, so I'm guessing he's never gutted this before. See here. That off. I do have a key, so if I lock it back up, no big deal. As long as this video is, I'm thinking it's probably gonna be okay. You know what? My tool's not wanting to work on this. Yeah, okay. It's too big. This is my screwdriver right there. Let's get this off of here. Come on now. There we go. Alright. Use the key. We will get the small follower through there. Ooh, I'm going to shim it because it's kind of a different size. The actuator on the back. There we go. Get that through. There we go. It is a 6-pinner, actually. So, yeah, look at that. All the key pins are in and working. Let's dump these key pins here. One, very tiny. That's why I was oversetting. Two is a serrated. Wow. Three, serrated. Four, serrated. Five, serrated. Six, serrated. Nothing done to the plug. All smooth in there. So, no counter milling or anything in the plug on that. Looks like, just for posterity for me, there's an indent in the front of this lock. So, that's how I know I'll put it back together. Alright. And in one, we have a standard, very tiny pins, spool. Ooh, wait, serrated spool. Did not see that before, but I do now. Okay. Spool. And another spool. Imagine that. Okay. Let's, all the springs are the same. Nothing going on there. and they're all at the shear line. Let's do a close-up of these pins so you guys can see what we had here. Get them situated. Everything's sticky from the factory. I really don't think he's been inside of this lock, so I guess maybe those weren't serrated spools. They're just regular spools, but at any rate, let's zoom in for you guys. And one, we had steel pins, so anti-drill, both standard in top and bottom. And two, we had a serrated key pin and a spool. Three, serrated key pin and a spool. Four was a standard and a spool. Five was a serrated key pin and a spool. And six is a serrated key pin and a spool. Awesome locks. Thank you very much, BlackDolphin90, for sending them to me. For all these locks, man, I really appreciate it. I will get this put back together, get these two Chubbs put in your package, and get them out to you. I'll send you a tracking on the email. But thank you very much for everything, man. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for your time, and don't break the law.